The NetSuite Intercompany time and expense feature accounts for the potential overlap of employee and customer transactions that affect two of your subsidiaries in your OneWorld NetSuite account. Let's take a quick look at this feature and how it works. First, let's get a quick overview of this feature. When the NetSuite Intercompany time and expense feature has not been enabled, any transactions entered for employees, vendors, and customers cannot involve any entities from other subsidiaries. But what if more than one subsidiary is involved in a single transaction? For example, suppose employees from subsidiary A do some work for customers from subsidiary B. With the intercompany time and expense feature, you can enter intercompany transactions like this. To set up intercompany time and expense, first, you'll need to enable the feature. You can turn on this feature under the Advanced Features section of the Accounting tab in Enable Features. Then you'll need to set a few preferences over in your Accounting Preferences. Set up Accounting Preferences, Accounting Preferences. On the General subtab, go to the OneWorld section and make sure you've chosen the Allow option for the Intercompany Time field and the Allow and Auto Adjust option for the Intercompany Expenses field. The Allow and Auto Adjust option turns on automated intercompany adjustments. Then save the page. To use the NetSuite Intercompany Time and Expense feature, there are a few things you should keep in mind. First, you need to know about the intercompany clearing account and how it works. The first time you enter a transaction affecting two of your subsidiaries, NetSuite will create the intercompany clearing account. This is a financial account that records the balancing debits and credits involved in an intercompany transaction. The intercompany clearing account falls into the Other Current Assets account category. You can rename this account, but you can't delete it or create another account to take its place. Each of your subsidiaries will have an intercompany clearing account, and any intercompany adjustments will always be recorded on the intercompany clearing account for the originating subsidiary in that subsidiary's currency. The originating subsidiary is the employee's subsidiary, while the related subsidiary is the subsidiary of the customer or project. How do you actually create an intercompany adjustment journal entry? You can create intercompany adjustments if you either are the administrator of your NetSuite account or have the intercompany adjustments permission as well as access to your company's subsidiaries. To create an intercompany adjustment journal entry, navigate to Transactions, Financial, Create Intercompany Adjustments. You can also access this page from the related tasks on the period close checklist. On the Create Intercompany Adjustments for Expenses and Time page, select the appropriate posting period. Any adjustments that need to be made for that period will appear in the list. Hit the Submit button once you've had a chance to look over the adjustments. This will create the related journal entries for each adjustment. Finally, you should be aware of some best practices if you're going to use the intercompany time and expense feature. The main idea of these best practices is that if you want something to work for intercompany transactions, it needs to be available to both subsidiaries involved. So, for one thing, you should use expense categories and service items that both the customer and the employee subsidiary have access to. Also, if you plan to use classifications in journal entries, you should make sure your classifications are global. Otherwise, make sure you've enabled the Allow Empty Classifications on Journals preference on the General subtab of Accounting Preferences. With the NetSuite Intercompany Time and Expense feature, NetSuite does a lot of the heavy lifting of intercompany transactions for you, ensuring that your finances accurately display what's happening in each of your subsidiaries. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, let us know by hitting the like button. And to learn more about how SuiteRep can help you with all of your NetSuite needs, visit us at suiterep.com.